Okay, so that's looking pretty good so far. Before we get started, I got some sticker shout-outs. Matt Haas over at Awesome Wood Things sent me one. Chad over at Mancrafting. Jody over at Inspire Woodcraft. The nice folks over at Arbor Vintage sent a sticker. Utkin over at MasterOfNone.tv, he sent a sticker. And last but not least, Steve over at Harneel Media and the Makers Media Network. One thing I want to mention before we get too far in is if you are a YouTube content creator and you want to grow your channel, the Makers Media Network is actually a pretty good way to help do that. There's a regular Google Hangout where some pretty big names show up pretty regularly, and you can talk to those folks about how to promote your channel, issues you may be having with video or other kinds of content production, whatever you may need. We're all here to help one another. And I'll make sure to leave links to all these channels and the Makers Media Network in the description below, so you can go check them out for yourself. It's a bunch of real nice folks, and all they care about is helping people create. Those of you who've been around the channel for a while know that one of the things I do to keep bread on the table is I make replacement parts for antique mechanisms, like 100-year-old cameras or 70-year-old cars. Today we've got a Lincoln Continental cruise control that has broken, and I need to make a replacement rack gear for it. This time I'm lucky enough to actually have an example of the part that's broken. Now if you take a look right here, there's a rack gear in there, and this pinion drives that rack gear. And what happens is the rack gear pulls on a cable. You can see on this one the end broke off. And it was made of nylon, but there was enough extra meat there that they got in and drilled an extra hole, and they were able to keep this one going. And unfortunately on this one, they did that once and then it broke too. This is made of nylon, this white rack gear, and this is it. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a new one of these from Delrin. So this is pretty small. It's about 1¾ inches long, 1/10 inch wide, 2/10 inch tall. And the angle of the gear teeth is 71 degrees, and there is no 71 degree router bit, so I can just mill this into a new plate and cut it up. So the way I'm going to do it is just the old-fashioned way, file it by hand. I did do a CAD model of the part, and the angle of the gear teeth is not anything standard, so I can't just go buy a bit. But if there's enough demand for this part amongst the Lincoln Continental owners that use these and have this pain in the butt issue that every one of them has by now, I'll go ahead and tool up and I'll just make the appropriate bit to cut this on the CNC milling machine. I tried to put a flat side on it with the bandsaw, but there was just too much flex in the blade, so I'm going to have to use the table saw for that. All right, now that's the right size and shape, but I'm going to leave it on the end of this so I can deal with it from way out here, because that damn saw is dangerous. Anyway, what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut the teeth in it. There's 15 teeth in it. I'm going to cut those in with a file, and then I'm going to slice two slices out of this thing. That I probably will do with the bandsaw, and then I'll just dress it up with the belt sander. Okay, so that's looking pretty good so far. We'll just keep on going that way and end up with a big rack. Now switching to that larger file was a mistake because the moment I did that, my tooth alignment got wider because the base of that file is not an actual knife edge. I'm going to have to start over. And it was at this point that I decided that I've had way too much time into this thing, so I went ahead and set up the CNC router, and I took a V-carving bit and ground it to 71 degrees, which was the angle of the teeth, and I just manually went ahead and cut the grooves for the teeth in it, and that actually turned out really well. Now I did it in both Delrin and Teflon,
just because I had pieces of both handy, and the Teflon one didn't turn out so great, but the Delrin one did.
Okay, now you get a look. There is the original. And when I line that up, that is right on it. So there it is. Success, my friends. Now let's take a couple slices with the bandsaw and see how it fits. So we'll come in here and just file that tear out off a little bit. Okay, so here we have the broken piece from the Lincoln Cruise Control, and here is the piece I made out of Delrin. Okay, well that is working exactly the way it should. This is a complete success. Well friends, that is a success. Now, there's a guy out there that he makes this part in aluminum and he gets $100 for it. Anyway, the Teflon one didn't turn out all that great, but the Delrin ones, they did. And that block that I cut on the router, I should be able to slice off about 10 of these. So if you or anyone you know has a perfect circle cruise control, they were used in all the cars, Studebaker, Oldsmobile, Cadillac, Lincoln. If they had cruise control in the 60s and had a speed control thumb wheel, it was probably made by Dana Perfect Circle. And this is probably broke in it, if they have it. And so here is your source, right here, $50. That's half the price of the aluminum guy. So that's all for this week. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe. Click up here to see my last video. Click over here to see something of mine that YouTube thinks you'll like. And have a good one.